Greg Klassen, you're the player assistant coach of the Piranhas. Welcome in Tilburg. Canadian-German.
Yeah, Canadian-German. I have my grandfather used to live in Germany, so I have it in the bloodlines, and so yeah, I have both passports now.
You started in Canada with the Nipawin Hawks. Yeah. Played in Canada, USA, Finland, Switzerland, Germany. So also NHL with Nashville, AHL with Milwaukee, and Dell with Kelowna High. Yeah. What is the difference between those leagues?
Oh, I mean, yeah, you name off all those teams, it's been a pretty long career, and there's played in a few different leagues. And I mean, it depends country to country. I think it's always a little bit different. North America, obviously, it was more straight line hockey. Maybe the era I grew up in was a lot more dump and chase style hockey. Like, don't be too fancy with the puck. You have to be very disciplined. And when I first came to Europe, I went to Finland, and I noticed that you could take more chances, play more one-on-one hockey, and play a little bit more with your skills. So it depends country to country. And then Germany was, I guess, a little bit more similar to North America. And yeah, it's just different from country to country.
You were educated in Canadian hockey? Especially when you come to Finland, they play more the Russian style.
Yeah, exactly. It's a little bit more puck control, but at the same time, it has a North American style to it as well. It's a pretty physical game over there. They're all really good skaters, and so it's got a mix of different styles.
Can you compare the NHL, AHL, and for example, the East Coast hockey? Can you compare that with Dell 2, and Oberliga?
Yeah, I mean, I guess it has the different tiers. Like the NHL obviously is the top players, as is the DEL in Germany. But I mean, the thing in North America is you're always changing between leagues in the season, where if you're not playing well in the NHL, you can get sent down to the AHL or the East Coast Hockey League. So you're never really safe. You have to always perform every night, because if you don't, someone will take your spot. Whereas in Germany, you're basically safe on your team for the year. You can't get changed to other teams during the season. So I think this is the biggest difference. In North America, there's always pressure every night to play well. Otherwise, somebody's going to take your spot. So
you're now 41 years. What do you have to do extra to stay in shape?
Yeah, I mean, it's at this age, you kind of know what your body needs to do. I think when I was around 27, 28, I started to do a lot of training on my own, because I knew what I needed. And I think every year you add stuff or you take stuff away that's going to help you. And I mean, yeah, by the time you're 35, you basically know what it takes, how much rest you need after the season, and how much training you need to do in order to stay in shape. But it's just something you have to keep on top of it. And yeah, it just becomes part of the lifestyle. And as you get older, I think you learn a little bit more how to take care of yourself.
You have a very great career. What's your highlight in your career?
Oh, man, I guess I would have to say that my first NHL game, or making the Nashville Predators. I was never drafted, so this was always like a big dream of mine that I wasn't sure was possible. But after a lot of hard work, and then I remember after the training camp in Nashville, the general manager called me in, and he said that I had made the hockey club. And this was probably the highlight of my career, and something that I'll never forget.
Do you think that it's very important for young players to play in other countries and other styles?
Yeah, I mean, it definitely doesn't hurt. It's a good experience if you can do it when you're younger. Even going to tournaments in other countries, I think you see different styles, and it can only help your game, because you're learning different styles, and this is something that's important as a player.
You were a cult star player for Milwaukee and the Nipawin Hawks. What kind of title is that?
I don't know where you get that, the cult player. Yeah, I guess it means that you were a big part of the organization. I mean, Nipawin Hawks was the junior team where I played for 4 years, and then Milwaukee Admirals, I think I was there for parts of 6 seasons. So, I mean, it's both teams that I played a lot of hockey with, so I guess that's how you get the title for that.
Because of your experience, you can help Coach Benke a lot. What's your role in the team?
Well, I'm basically here obviously I have experience. I've played like almost 20 seasons professionally, so I try to just bring an example for the young guys and try to do the right things. But I'm also here this year to help Thomas and Christian with the coaching. I don't have as big of roles as them, but I'm helping with the practices and just like with X's and O's between periods and stuff like that. So just trying to the three of us work together, and we try to help make the game plans and try to work together.
In December, the Rostock Piranhas had a very good series, a lot of wins. except on the 30th of December. A 9-0 against Halle. What happened?
Yeah, I mean, it was a little bit embarrassing, unfortunate game for us. It just seemed like everything that they shot went in the net. And then it was just like a snowball. It kept getting worse and worse. We couldn't get back in the game, and it was just one of those nights I guess we want to forget, because this is not the style of hockey we want to play. We're normally a team who likes to play defensively and not give up many goals. So this one we try to just put an X on, and we move forward. And like you said, we had some success in December. We got ourselves in a good position. So we forget about that one, and we just try to get better moving forward.
Latest news hot today is that Tilburg Trappers will stay in the Oberliga also next year. What do you think as a player from that?
Yeah, I guess I'm always asking the question if they will go in the DEL2 or not. It's always a discussion, but I mean, I guess the DEL2 has their rules and regulations, and now that you said they're coming back here next year, I mean, it's only good for the Oberliga, for teams like us. You know, it brings our competition up. It makes us, like, try to raise our level of hockey. So I think it's good for this league, and I mean, they're obviously, it's a great organization. They're well coached, the organization, good fans, good arena. So it's a place I think that other teams try to model after, and it's really good for the Oberliga if they stay.
What will it be this evening?
This evening, well, we're coming in. We know we have to be come in with a good game plan. We have to be disciplined, because if you get lazy, or if you try to play high risk against these guys, you don't have much of a chance. So we have a game plan. We're coming here to work hard. We're coming here to win a hockey game, and we'll see what happens.